music director for Center for Spiritual Living in Los Angeles, and I'm going to start this beautiful morning with a song for Pride Month.
Spiewak. I love the last lines. I've forgotten that those were the last lines of "Don't be a drag, just be a queen." So that will be that will be our guidance for today as we have our Gay Pride Sunday celebration here in the land of USA and in Los Angeles and in the land of West Hollywood where I am. Good morning, everyone. Happy to have you all here with us today, and thank you for being here on this day, June 14th, in the year 2020, in the land of Los Angeles and in the land of West Hollywood and in the land of wherever you may be joining us from, either through Zoom and or technology, or if you're here in person. I'd like to invite each and every one of you to turn your cameras off at this point, if you would please do that, and let's keep those off until we get to the end of the service, and then I'll ask you to turn them back on as we come together at that point, and this will indeed save up space for us on the screen that we need to present to you this most wonderful service. Once again, welcome to everyone, wherever you may be joining us from, whether that's live, in person, or at a later date. My name is Reverend Dr. Keith Cox, and I'm the spiritual leader here for the Center for Spiritual Living. We come together every Sunday morning to commune in spirit, to honor the individualistic nature of the only thing that exists. In our philosophy and faith and way of life known as the teachings of the science of mind, a new thought philosophy, We believe and practice and teach and preach that all that there is God. Matters not if that word works for you or if it doesn't work for you, because it's not about the word. It's about an understanding that there is a power that is omniscient and omnipresent and exists throughout all of the universe, and that it individualizes itself by means of you and by means of me. And so we come together each and every Sunday morning and various other times to honor that power and to honor that presence that exists within us, and to acknowledge that in the myriad of ways in which it expresses itself by means of you and by means of me. So if you're joining us here for the first time, please know that we don't follow traditional religious values and practices in that sense of, we don't believe that the power is outside of us. It is within us. And we honor not only each and every individual, but everyone on their journey of awakening to who they know themselves to be as a spiritual being. Our vision statement for our community is supporting individuals finding their personal self-empowerment through a spiritual awakening. So I invite you to hear that again. We support individuals finding their personal self-empowerment through a spiritual awakening. This is no more true today than any other day on Pride Sunday, and yet it seems to hold a bit of special meaning, certainly for me, I know for many of you, when we carve out this day, certainly in Los Angeles and many other cities around the world, to come together and to honor who we are as a divine being and the uniqueness that was oppressed for many, many years. And I will be addressing that in my message today. And so before we move forward into our morning ritual, I'd like to take a moment and just remind you to keep your cameras turned off if you're joining us through Zoom. If you're joining us through Facebook, obviously you won't be able to be seen on screen or see that, but just know that there are moments that some of our congregants turn their cameras on and look into their camera, looking into the screen to see if they can see themselves or seeing what they're looking at. And when that happens, I will reach over and turn their camera off. So know that that may pop up on this journey of us all finding our personal self-empowerment through a spiritual awakening today. Speaking of turning cameras on, I'd like to introduce you to someone today that is our guest musician that I'm so very excited to have him here with us today. His name is Todd Alsop. He's joining us from Provincetown, California right now. And Todd is an amazing musician with a beautiful voice. And as I say on often Sundays, a great gift. And Todd definitely has a gift to share with us today. And so Todd, can you turn your camera on and say a hello to us? I'm going to ask him to start his video. And while we're doing that, we'll... There he is.
There I am.
There he is. Good morning, Todd.
Thank you.
So everyone, I'd like to introduce you to us. Obviously, what I'm doing is for you to meet Todd Alsop, who is our musician this morning. And he's going to bring some really fun and beautiful and uplifting and inspiring and rainbow flag-oriented music for us today. So, Todd, so happy to have you joining us from Provincetown, Massachusetts. How is it on the Cape today?
Quiet, lovely, beautiful, warm, and very quiet.
Oh, I'm so happy to hear that it is, and it breaks my heart. I wish I was there with you, both while it's quiet, and I love to be on that Cape when it's kind of loud and raucous. So we'll let you be loud and raucous for the Cape today as you inspire us later in song. So we look forward to seeing you later as you bring us beautiful music. We move forward in our service today with our morning ritual. We open our service every Sunday morning with a ritual called Calling in the Light. And the purpose of this ritual is for us to anchor ourselves into the power and the presence of the light that exists within you and within me. Over the last couple of Sundays, we have done our candle lighting just a little bit different. Not only have we done it in a virtual setting, but we've done it in a way that has honored what's taking place in the marches in the world today, as well as honoring our theme this month, which is Pride, a Way of Life. And so right now, as we open our morning ritual, I would like to invite you to take a deep breath in and to begin to honor that power that exists within all of us. And if you haven't closed your eyes yet, or if you have and feel like opening them, you can look at the image on the screen that is a reflection of the chakras that exist within each and every one of us. These sources of energy within our body that spin in a centrifugal manner at a speed that is beyond comprehension, but their purpose is to not only bring in the energy of the light of life, but that we can use it to anchor ourselves into our spiritual truth, as well as to then use that energy as we put it back out into the universe, knowing that a ripple effect is indeed unfolding. And so today, as we light this candle, letting the flickering flame of the rainbow candle on our screen be a reminder to us that yes, Spirit has placed the stamp of individuality upon itself and called it you, but that we're each a vital piece and part of the puzzle of life itself. Just as each grain of sand matters on our planet, we do as well. And so on this date, Sunday, June 14th in the year 2020, as we continue to evolve in this revolution of Black Lives Matter and calling for justice to be reformed on our planet, we also honor and acknowledge the history, the present moment, and the future of the movement known as the Gay Pride Movement. And so we light this candle. Choosing peace as the way. And as I affirm that which Mahatma Gandhi has written for us, I affirm it for each one of us, as I know that you each affirm it for all other aspects of humanity, as well as we do so for the lives lost at the hands of injustice, whether they be young, Black, brown, men or women of color, our brothers and sisters of the gay movement and its evolution. And today, honoring those transgendered lives that are taken so ruthlessly and with such disregard. And the affirmation is this: I offer you peace. I offer you love. I offer you friendship. I see your beauty. I hear your need. I feel your feelings. For my wisdom flows from the highest source. And I salute that source in you. For let us work together. For let us work together for unity and of peace. Yaron will now lead us in song of Let There Be Peace on Earth. The lyrics are on the screen, and I invite you to sing along.
With God.
soul a vow to take each moment and live each moment with peace eternally. Let there be peace on earth and let it begin with me.
So I invite you to close your eyes if they aren't still closed, to go within, and let's have a spiritual mind treatment, also known as an affirmative prayer. It's prayer, John, in an affirmative and declarative state. And so I affirm and declare right now that we each open our mind, our heart, our soul, and our being to be the catalyst for peace on earth today. That we each understand that within the complexity of mind itself and being individualized expressions of this mind, the one mind, we not only have the capacity to hold the idea that peace can exist on this planet and that marches can take place to stop injustices, and we can mourn for those who have lost their lives, and we can be conscious evolutionist and work towards change, and we can be fragile and sad and heartbroken and optimistic and forthright and direct. It all can exist simultaneously because there truly is only one thing taking place, and that is the activity of the divine source, the thing itself, and yes, even the word God. And so today I affirm for each of us that we open our mind in a way to receive a spark of a new idea that is a catalyst for us to stand up, to rise up, and to be a conscious participant in this evolutionary process that honors each and every individual as being worthy of the same rights, life, and quality of life as all others. And so that evolution may sometimes seem like a revolution, but we choose to keep our minds right as we move forward with a deep faith, with great trust, and with a readiness to grow and grow and grow, with a deep sense of gratitude for having the opportunity to participate at this level and to know who we are. We release this affirmative prayer out into the creative ethers of the universe, knowing that it must be made manifest. And so we're ready to receive it as it shows up as we close this prayer by saying together, "And so it is. Amen." Thank you. Thank you, Yaron. And thank you to each and every one of you who sang along and listened and received information as it came your way. As I introduced our musician earlier this morning, I shared with you, I'm so happy to not only have gotten to know this young man a bit over the last week during our rehearsals, but have heard amazing things about him prior to him coming into our sphere of experience. He's here to share a beautiful, beautiful song with us today and his gifts, and he is a powerhouse of talent. Todd, are you ready to share it with us? So he's coming on. There he is. So Todd, will you tell us the title of the song that you're singing and anything about it you'd like for us to know?
It's a good old Pride classic called When Love Takes Over.
Wonderful. Well, ladies and gentlemen, everything beyond and in between, Todd Alsop.
Oh,
Thank you. I don't know that you can see it, but you're getting applause from our virtual audience, Todd. So thank you so very much. When Love Takes Over. Beautiful, beautiful lyrics, and certainly a most direct and correct guide and instruction for us during this time on our planet, and certainly during this time of gay pride. So your love is taking over. So thank you for sharing your love with us. I'll invite you back in to do another song after my message. So take care. We'll see you shortly. When love takes over, he sings to us. What he's informing us here is love both at that human level, but also love from the spiritual level, which I speak of so often from the podium, both in person when we would gather together at our home at 1200 North La Brea, but also now in person as this has transpired for us as a virtual ministry, a virtual community, a virtual platform to continue providing a safe space for each and every individual to find their personal self-empowerment through a spiritual awakening. Love is that sense of the divine, but love also that human love. It's Gay Pride, everybody. And speaking of love, we're here today to celebrate Gay Pride, the love of what is really known in our world as the love of same gender, really is what it was thought of when Pride came into being. But today in our very modern world, we look at Pride as that opportunity to come together and not only celebrate love, but celebrate equality and to celebrate the progress that we've made, to celebrate the humanity that has evolved into a greater expression today, both politically and legally and personally and educationally. There's so much that has transpired, certainly just in my life of 6 years, but I know for many of you who have been on this earth a bit longer than that, that there have been times when that wasn't the case. And I have said to my son before, who is a gay man who's 30 years old, it's important for us all to stop and remember all of those that came before us that gave us the ability to be who we are in the way that we are in the world today. And so today is not the first day that gay pride has existed. And if it were existing in its original format right now, we know that there would be a parade about to start in West Hollywood that would begin with our dykes on bikes, and there would be dancers on floats, and there would be PFLAG, the parents that support LGBT children, and there would be people that had just come in from riding the AIDS ride, a fundraiser for the LA Gay and Lesbian Center, LA LGBT, as well as the San Francisco AIDS Foundation. And so many activities would be unfolding, certainly in the very immediate surroundings of where I live and many of you, but that's actually taking place or would have been taking place across the country and even more so around the world today. And so gay pride is something that's important for us to stop and to acknowledge. I want to give us a bit of a history lesson today as we look at pride and why it's important to keep the journey, the evolution of this movement in context, not only of what has occurred prior to this very moment, but why it's so important to stay connected to our journey to continue the evolutionary process of the rights that we as LGBTQ plus people have earned on this planet, and not take for granted those rights, and to be very cohesive in how we go from here. The LGBT Pride Month, as it's known now, used to be just a day and then a weekend, and now it's the month of June, occurs around the world to commemorate the Stonewall Riots, which occurred at the end of June in 1969. Now, as a result, many Pride events have been held this month to recognize the impact that the LGBT people have had around the world. And what it does, Pride, it raises awareness. Well, awareness, you might ask, and sometimes there's been a true controversy around, is the awareness being presented in the correct way of go-go dancers on floats and blatant expression of sexuality in public? But it's important to know that, yes, it does indeed raise awareness. And it's important to understand the journey that we've all been on to get to this point where, yes, even things that may not necessarily be considered socially acceptable are all rooted in the need to rise up and express the individual nature of the individual as they're owning who they are, so that love takes over and there's no shame in the game of being an LGBTQ plus person. So yes, it indeed raises awareness. And it also is an acknowledgement that we as gay people do exist. And as I said before, to remember that the rights that we have in this modern day society, even though there is an attempt through our current administration to remove those, that there are many, many, many places in the world today where it's illegal to act upon what your innate desires are relative to your sexual orientation. It's an opportunity for those that are not LGBT, but an ally, to come together and celebrate, to have there be a demarcation once within the year to, as I've said before, honor the history, do an inventory of where we are, make a plan for going forward. It's a safe space for the closeted LGBTQ people to celebrate in their own manner. That there, many of us are out and proud, to say the least, but there are also individuals that that's not the case. And it's important to give them space on their journey as long as they're not using their power in today's world to oppress those that they're shameful for actually being. It's also a time to, as I've said before, to honor our history and shine a light on our beloved community known as LGBTQ+. Now, for those of you that may have never encountered me before, please know that when I say our, I am an openly gay, out and loud, proud man. And so Stonewall, we acknowledge. Stonewall is known as the day that the first brick was thrown, if you will, to start the gay revolution that has caused the freedoms that are now to fall into place, the history that has, where our people had said, we no longer will stand for this. And as you can see from the screen, our beloved Marsha P. Johnson, who along with Sylvia Rivera, are considered the faces of this movement, as she said in her most wonderful transgendered way into a microphone, "Darling, I want my gay rights now. And what both Marsha P. Johnson and Sylvia Rivera did was stand up, along with many, many, many others that had come before her, both in New York City, where the Stonewall Bar is, and across the nation, including Los Angeles, had come to the point where no longer was it acceptable for there to be police brutality against people of the LGBTQ family. Now, for me, as I use that term, police brutality, it creates a resonance field as to what's transpiring today for Black Lives Matter that are being screamed from the mountaintops today and lauded and heralded as marches are taking place with the intent of exactly the same thing that took place in 1969 at the Stonewall riots and prior to that, is that no more is this acceptable. Many of our beloved community who would be marching today are all in Hollywood getting ready for a large trans Black Lives Matter march to take place from Hollywood into West Hollywood. There's an estimated 10,000 people that will march there today. And I want to say on behalf of the Los Angeles LGBT spiritual community that I'm just a voice of here, we're so proud of you and here with you in heart, mind, and soul and being until we can be later today. This march is taking place in lieu of gay pride, and I think it's important for us to know that we're here to stand with all of humanity on this evolution of equality, equanimity, and justice for everyone. For the truth is, as we know that we are all one. We come to this world with different skin colors, with different hair texture, with different gender, with different sexual orientation, with different, because that's how we're made. And that is something for us to celebrate, not to oppress. It's something for us to honor, to not fear. It's something for us to stand up for and not hide away from. The image on the screen shows us that we are indeed all different. And as I said earlier, one of my favorite quotes of Dr. Ernest Holmes that was actually on the brochure of our church, which was used to be known as the Los Angeles Church of Religious Science every Sunday, that spirit has placed the stamp of individuality upon itself and called it you. What that means to me is not only are we supposed to be different, we're designed that way, but we're here to celebrate it. And so in the vein of celebration, we are here today to not only honor gay pride and the gay pride movement and to honor the Black Lives and the Black Lives movements and all of the movements that I spoke of last week that have been movements to create a shift for humanity. What is required for this shift to unfold is for us to stand up as people, as humans, as expressions of spirituality, and take our power and use it in a way to invoke change. I love this photograph that I just placed on the screen, and I don't know the date, but this beautiful woman, and this woman in this kind of prairie dress with her placard that says gay power, black power, women power, student power, all power to the people. It's the people taking back their power that will create the revolution that is needed for the evolution to take root in our system. Gay pride is what we're celebrating today and is considered what, after that first brick was thrown in Stonewall, to be known as the gay revolution. The gay revolution. What we're all here to celebrate and acknowledge today is the song and the lyrics, just as your own sang to us earlier today, "Baby, I was born this way." Well, what does that mean? It means that we were born just exactly how we are. A complete, perfect, whole, spiritual being expressing our humanity in a way, to the best way that we know how to do that, to magnify our divinity. And yet on this journey, there may be times when the individual needs to alter their physicality to match their spirituality, and that too is okay. Because what we've learned over this time is that what we used to think is sexuality is just simply the way the individual is attracted to another being for their sexual nature. But there are other facets to that. And as spiritual beings that practice the teachings of the science of mind, we understand the need to understand facets. We oftentimes understand the facets of mind as conscious mind, subjective mind, and affect. The facets I'm speaking of relative to sexuality and gender is there's the sexual orientation of the individual, what that individual sees that turns them on basically romantically. And then the next aspect of that or facet of that is how you're born. What is the physical nature of how you're born? And does that match how you see yourself? And so oftentimes and many times individuals are born and the chemistry in the DNA within them does not match what their brain or their heart tells them they are to look like or what they're attracted to. And so fortunately, we live in a world today where science can alter that through chemistry and through surgery so that the individual can feel whole. Feel whole doesn't necessarily mean making them whole because they're already whole as they are because they were born this way, baby. And the last facet and aspect of that is expression. How does an individual show up in the world and express to the world who they know themselves to be based on their gender and oftentimes their sexual orientation? Today is not the first time that anyone on our planet has had to fight for their rights. We know that that has taken place in the civil rights movement and the women's rights movement and the trans movement and fighting against war. And so today in our history lesson, I would like us to look at this beloved individual who fought for our rights. His name is Bernard Rustin. And he declared that we need in every community a group of angelic troublemakers, for our power is in our ability to make things unworkable. What we're being told by Bernard is that we have to stand up. We have to rise up and do our parts once we know that we know that we know that injustice is taking place on our planet, and to do our part to make things unworkable until they are righted. Now, he, Bernard Rustin, was quite a man in his day. In 1953, Bernard Rustin, as a civil rights organizer, was arrested in Pasadena, California, for having consensual sex with men. He served 50 days in jail and was registered as a sex offender. He went on to play a key role in the civil rights movement, working closely with Martin Luther King, but his conviction remained a stain on his reputation. And I know that there are those of you that are on this meeting today that's watching this service that lived during this time, and you too may have had a similar experience because during that era, it was illegal to have sex with someone of the same gender. Bernard, and so I want you to know that I hear you and I see you today, and I honor any harm and degradation or disrespect that took place for you in that day, and hope that today is a day that healing can take place and we can support you in honoring who you are as a divine being expressing your humanity. In that context, Rustin wrote, "I know now that for me, sex must be sublimated if I am to live with myself and in this world longer." Generations, as I spoke a moment ago, of LGBT people, I'm sorry, I need to go back just one second. The generations of LGBT people, including countless gay men, were branded criminals and sex offenders simply because they had had consensual sex, the reporter said in a statement as they were praising Governor Gavin Newsom's actions for pardoning Bernard Rustin for his anti-gay charges. These acts were often life-ruining and many languished on the sex offender register for decades. Rustin was stripped of his leadership post at the Fellowship of Reconciliation, a pacifist organization involved in the civil rights movement, after Senator Strom Thurmond of South Carolina read Rustin's arrest record file into the congressional record. Now, Rustin was a great American who was both gay and black at a time when the sheer fact of being either or both could land you in jail. This was said in a statement praising Governor Gavin Newsom. For he went on to say, this pardon assures his rightful and respectful place in history. I share that with you today as a reminder that many have walked the path for us to be where we are today. June 14th in the year 2020, celebrating Pride in a manner that none of us could have predicted months ago. Many seeking to want to be on the streets, marching and partying and playing and having fun and celebrating. But times are different today. And so, as I said earlier, I honor my LGBT rainbow brothers and sisters and everything in between and beyond, for they are now out marching for Black Lives Matter. And because we have the rights that we do today, it's important for us to remember that it's time to reach out a hand and support those that are in need as well. And so my message for us today is to invite ourselves to look inward and ask ourselves, what can we do to help? How can we be a catalyst for change today? And to understand the importance of owning our LGBTQ aspects of our life and to understand this journey of coming out and being open in public. Our beloved Rabbi Denise Eger, who is the rabbi at Congregation Kol Ami, the space that we've shared for over 4 years now, writes this in her Wednesday Wisdom publications. The act of coming out as an LGBTQI person is an act of holiness and courage. Pride Month reminds us love is love, and to work for equality and justice for queer folks everywhere. I want to take a moment and acknowledge that word for queer folks everywhere, because I'm of a generation, as I'm sure many of you are, that word is considered to be disrespectful. And yet it's not today, and certainly it has been used disrespectfully for many years. But if you're not aware, I'd like to inform you that those of a younger generation have reclaimed that word to use it as a word to stand proud representing the many facets of who they are in this rainbow coalition known as the LGBTQI community. And so if it rubs you the wrong way, I'm sorry that I've posted that for you for that. And I'm also asking you to have a new thought and to understand it in a new way. For I have certainly walked that path and I've learned to do that. Pride Month, she says, is an opportunity for us to be reminded that love is love and to work for equality and justice for queer folks everywhere. For the act of coming out as an LGBTQI plus person is an act of holiness and courage. An act of holiness and courage. I believe she means that to come out and to honor who we are as a being of light in our most authentic manner, which oftentimes has been oppressed and suppressed, is indeed holy. It's that calling forth of the light from within, and that indeed does take courage to stand up, to stand proud, and to own who you are fully and completely in the world. And so courage is also what is required for us today to determine what is required of us to stand up and to rise up and to be a participant and a catalyst for change in the world of injustice today, and to support not only the Black Lives Movement, that all Black Lives Matter, meaning trans as well. The vision statement for the community that's known as the Center for Spiritual Living, for which we are a member of, is a creating a world that works for everyone. And as many of you have heard me say over the years, I find this vision to be a bit lofty and hard to understand. And yet, what we've experienced in the last few months reminds me that it's important for us to hold this vision, to not only hold it, but to also act in accordance day by day, thought by thought, action by action, in a way that not only holds the vision as a possibility, but to do my part for it becoming a reality. To do our part to help co-create happy adults, and that takes place by treating children and creating a world for children in a way where they feel safe, that they do not feel less than or marginalized or wrong for their skin color or for their economic status, or who they identify as LGBTQI plus or heterosexual. That the world that we have created for them before may not be a perfect world, but we can start anew today, righting our wrongs. and continuing to express unconditional love and creating this safe space for them. And to know that it is important to share and to create and participate in this unconditional love, both as a human and as a divine being, because it's inherent within us as a divine being. But to also understand that alone will not make the changes that are needed in our world today. That it's important for us to be conscious participants in making sure that there's no more oppression. Oppression is defined as a prolonged, cruel, or unjust treatment or control. It's the state of being subject to unjust treatment or control, or mental pressure or distress. And so you and I have the opportunity today to be willing to do our part to diminish the oppression on our planet. For what we know that all oppression is connected and interconnected because you and I are interconnected. And so looking back on Gay Pride and remembering to celebrate that today, Stonewall means fight back, smash gay oppression that was taking place leading up to 1969. It's important for us to remember that oppression can only survive through silence. That you and I, should we desire to be a participant in this evolutionary, revolutionary process that's being called forth on our planet today, we must be willing to stand up, to rise up, to act up, and to speak out. Desmond Tutu tells us that neutrality is not acceptable. That if you are neutral in situations of injustice, you've chosen the side of the oppressor. And I know for you, and I know for me, there are times when we can ask ourselves, where do we go from here? But we're also being told, as I shared with us last week, we have opportunity, connected to opportunity, connected to opportunity to do our part. It's not new on our planet. Robert F. Kennedy, the Attorney General, the brother of the slain President John F. Kennedy, and the gentleman who worked with Martin Luther King, gave us this instruction to know about making a change and being a part of stopping the oppression. He says, few will have the greatness to bend history itself, but each of us can work to change a small portion of events. It is from numberless diverse acts of courage and belief that human history is shaped. Each time a man, meaning male, female, everything in between and beyond, stands up for an ideal or acts to improve the lot of others or strikes out against injustice, that man sends forth a tiny ripple of hope. And crossing each other from a million different centers of energy and daring those ripples build a current which can sweep down the mightiest walls of oppression and resistance. What we're being told here is that all that is required for each of us to participate in this ripple effect is to have the courage to rise up and to take action. For equality is what is being sought after. But in researching for this message that I have today, I've come to such a new aha. And I invite you to do the same. We're a teaching community of that which is known as the New Thought teaching. And so today I invite you to be willing to have a new thought, to understand that equality indeed is important, that we view that as all cultures, all religions, all genders, all LGBTQ, all colors, all ages, all transgender, all homosexuals, all heterosexuals, all humans, all gays, all bisexuals, all that identify, we all indeed deserve equality. But is it enough? Is it enough? Equality, as this image shows us, is the assumption that everyone benefits from the same supports. That's equal treatment. But it shows us here that yes, each individual can be given a support to stand on. So everyone's been given the same support, but it doesn't give each individual the opportunity to be a conscious participant. So then we think that the next step is equity. Equity here is where everyone gets the support that they need. The boxes have been moved around so that each individual has the ability to view what is transpiring in the world that they would like to participate in. Everyone gets the support they need. That's the concept of affirmative action, thus producing equity. But today, on this gay pride in the year 2020, and knowing what is transpiring on our planet relative to Black Lives Matter and police brutality, let's go further. It's time for us to consciously participate in justice for all. And this image shows us what justice looks like. Justice, where all three can see the game, the very thing they want to participate in, without supports or accommodations, because the causes of the inequity has been addressed. The systemic barrier has been removed. That's what we're here to do, ladies and gentlemen, is to be participants in removing those systemic barriers that are causing injustices on our planet today. We cannot pretend as if we don't know. And we can't live in that age-old, early 20th century model of metaphysics of it's all about me. This week, one of my peers in the ministerial movement posted this statement: a truth student minds their own affairs, leaving others free to express life as they see fit. And yes, on some degree, that is true. But that's not enough. It's not enough. Because as we all know, and you've heard me say it over and over again, and it rings more true today than ever, we're not here to be our brothers and sisters keepers. We're here to be our brothers and sisters and to stand up for them when they cannot stand up for themselves. And so it's not enough for it to be about me. It's important for us to remember it's not about me. It's about we, which is inclusive of the me. And so today, let's you and I open our mind and our heart and our soul and our being to have a new thought, to be a conscious participant, to act in accordance to a me to we movement, so that all humans may live with pride on our planet. And it is important, yes, to still be proud to be me, but we can be proud to be me as well as being a conscious participant of me to we. Well, where do we start? We start by continuing to build a consciousness prior to taking the action, and to remember that love, the self-givingness of spirit, whose desire is to create more of itself out of itself, and the only way it can do it is through you and through me. For love is love. Is love. Is love. Is love. Is love, is love. And when love takes over, as Todd sang to us earlier, it's important to remember that when it takes over your heart, mind, and soul, there are no guarantees that you will necessarily be loved back in the same way. And that's the point. That's the point. Love because you love, not because you expected anything in return. Choose to be a conscious mirroring, a reflector of the nature of nature, which is to give. Knowing that you don't have to have an expectation it will return. Its nature is that it must return. And so today, on Gay Pride, in the year 2020, as we're choosing to love and remembering that we were instructed and agreed last week to rise up, that we're here to make a difference. We're here to make a difference on this planet. And we rise up by relaxing into spirit, which energizes that universal interconnected power that is within us. And as we relax into this energy that is life itself, allowing it to energize the oneness of life that exists between you and between me and between all expressions of spirit itself, we have the opportunity to live anew, because oppression is not an okay thing. Nelson Mandela tells us when a man is denied the right to live their life that they believe in, they have no choice but to become an outlaw. And so today I'm not encouraging us to go out and be a traditional outlaw of breaking laws, but I want us to remember that these upheavals, these revolutions, this evolution that has indeed transpired on our planet has been as a result of someone throwing a brick and saying enough is enough. The Rainbow Revolution. And so we have the opportunity today to have a light bulb moment, a lavender light bulb moment, to honor all who have come before us today, that allows us to live our lives out and proud, and to have a light bulb moment, to ask ourselves, what can I do now so that I'm co-creating healthy adults? What can I do to support my brothers and my sisters so that everyone feels safe, loving freely? Because we know that in each of us, there's a desire to know, speak, and to love freely. And I know that you know, along with me, we both know that love is love is love, no matter how it shows up chronologically, the colors of our skin, who we love, how we love, why we love. We're here to love freely and to support those as they do so. And support them not just emotionally and mentally, but physically and legally in an evolutionary manner, and march for them and declare for them and demand for them that everyone deserves to be able to love. And so here we are. Pride. Have it. Live it. Be it. And how do we do that? We do it as a way of life. That's how we live life with pride. Being proud of knowing that we've done our part in that evolutionary process. And it begins by loving who you are today. Right now. This moment. For we are family. Sister Sledge sang the song for us. We are family. And so I invite you to take a deep breath in. Anchor this moment in. So we open our mind, open our heart, open our soul, open our being to move forward with, as, the grace of the divine. And so it is. And so I invite you to get ready to sing along a song that I may have done a little justice to and a little injustice to just a moment ago. But Todd's going to come back and sing this great Sister Sledge song for us, with us. And I invite you where you are today to feel your rainbow flag and let it fly as he sings for us the song We Are Family, and get up and dance and carry on. He may need a little bit of help getting his camera on, so let me get to him. Here we go.
I'm good.
Here we go. Are we good? All righty. So thank you. And I bring back to our screen the one and only Todd Alsup from Provincetown, Massachusetts, where I'm sure there are rainbow flags a-flying. Todd and congregation, get up and dance.
Feel free to sing with me, y'all.
We are family.
Yes, Todd Alsop. Thank you. I know everybody was up and dancing around, Todd. So thank you. We are family. Ah, claps, claps, claps all across the board. Tens, tens, tens all across the board. Good. Thank you, Todd. Thank you. Look forward to having you with us again another day. So absolutely. So, all right, everyone. Well, now is the time for us to come together and support our community financially. I'll put on the screen the ways to do that and just know that it's all deeply appreciated. We are a community that both thrives and continues to exist based on the financial contributions of those that consciously give. And so that's exactly what is transpiring today as well. And so we please know in advance that all that you give today is deeply and greatly appreciated. And so your options are to go to our website and type in CSL-LA.org and click on donate, or you can go into the app store, and which our app is known as Center for Spiritual Living Los Angeles, and click on the upper left bars. The screen will come up and see a donate tab, as well as oftentimes in the chat window, you can go down and Rob will have placed a direct link for that. If those options are not good for you, you can mail in a check. Our address is on the screen, as well as You can find it on our website. Sorry, I'm a little out of breath from dancing. And you can also call me at some point if you'd like for help with that one-on-one over the phone. And I just want to say once again, thank you all for your financial support always, but certainly during these most unique times in how we are doing ministry. And so thank you, thank you, thank you. So as Jeroen is going to sing our song for our donation times, that'll give us each an opportunity to consciously give, and I will close that out with an affirmative prayer. So I affirm for each of us that yes, love is our decision. And today, as we participate in the conscious giving for the Center for Spiritual Living Los Angeles, it's a reflection of our intention to be participants in the abundance of the universe. So it's a deep awareness of good that exists that we consciously participate in, knowing that as we send out this ripple effect, it returns to us multiplied abundantly. And so today is the day that we grow and expand and evolve and declare that we are each and all of us collectively more and more prosperous and abundant, because that is a reflection of who we are as spiritual beings. Being one with the one, we let it be, and here we grow again, and so it is. Thank you, Jeroen. So just want to give you all a little update on what's going on here at the Center for Spiritual Living Los Angeles. So we are a community that is, as most are, all absolutely online right now. And so know that everything that, I'm sorry, I'm having a difficult time with the screen. Just one second. There we go. So we appreciate not only your financial giving, but your participation with us as a community. So there have been questions as to when and if we will go back into the building. I just want you to know that the board is having conversation around that right now. We're going to stay with the format that we're on and know that that's where we're at till it's going to be safe for us and economically feasible for us to make a different decision. And so just know that you'll be updated on that, not only through the communication that goes out via email and on our social media sites, as well as if something changes in that regard, I'll make sure that a telephone call goes out to all of you. I invite you to continue reaching out to our fellow community members, as well as to invite others in to have our community grow during these times. We would love for that to happen. We will continue this week with our Wednesday coffee clutch, which is a time to come together on Wednesdays at noon to do a check-in and have just an open conversation around what's transpiring on our planet. So know that you and anyone is invited to do that. That information is all on our website, csl-la.org, as well as you can find it through our social media sites on Facebook and or Instagram. We are putting on hold our Thursday evening snappy hour. The turnout's been low, and I think right now it's time to put that on the back burner and to imagine some new things to be for community for us as far as gathering together. I'd love for you all to send any ideas that you may have in for us to gather together in some fun ways. I'm researching some, and so just know that that'll show up soon, as well as my goal in the next couple of weeks to announce to you a class that we'll do for a 4-week class online. Also know that a survey will come out to you in the next 2 weeks, just asking you some questions regarding what your preferences are in regards to online community and anything that you'd like to know or say or learn. Know that that's coming your way. So certainly be open to that. Once again, a big thank you to all of you for being here today, whether you're joining us through Zoom and or whether you're joining us through Facebook and eventually a recording through our YouTube channel. A big thank you to our musicians today. Thank you, Yaron Spiewak, for sharing your talent with us today, as well as the work that you do in preparing everything for the week. Big thank you to Yaron. A huge thank you to Todd, joining us from Provincetown, for bringing your talent and your gifts to us today. And we have a surprise for you with Todd after the service, if you all will hang on. Just know that. And also a big thank you to Travis Smith, who works so diligently with us throughout the week to make sure that technologically we are doing the best that we can through an audiovisual perspective. And then also a big thank you to Robert Hensley, who does not only our administrative work, but certainly does all of our social media work and manages the balance of all of this while this is transpiring on a Sunday. So know that that's happening. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to reach out to me throughout the week. You can find all of my contact information on our website, as well as we have a group of practitioners. Should you need guidance regarding anything that's transpiring in the world today, feel free to reach out to them for not only spiritual guidance, but for knowing and affirming spiritual truth with you during this time. So we're going to close with the meditations, and after the meditation, we will disconnect from Facebook, and at that point, we will stay on and have a little surprise and have a little coffee clatch together. So I'll let you know when it's time to turn your cameras on. So let's go into meditation. So as we anchor ourselves into the oneness of life, we give ourselves permission to open our ears, our minds, our hearts, to be guided into a new thought and into a light bulb moment of how we're being called to be a participant in the change that is being called for on the planet today. This calling doesn't diminish any work that's been done prior to now. And all the work that each and every one of you have done that has led us to this moment, whether it's through the equal rights movement, civil rights movement, the gay rights movement, or any other elements, so that we may live life the way that we do today. Thank you. And we're ready to go arm to arm, heart to heart, hand to hand with you forward, as we consciously and purposefully walk the talk of creating a world that works for everyone. For here, we grow again.